I was taken by the moon, looking down on everything I never knew. I'm awakened by the truth, and only for a moment I'm alive with you.
Hello everybody, welcome back to Gal, and today we are going to be covering how to use Lumetri curves. What the heck are they? How do you use them? Why are they there? I don't know, that might be how you're feeling right now, but I'm going to solve that for you in this video. Now a couple weeks ago I covered how to use Lumetri color scopes and the panels, so you guys should watch that because it really gives you a foundation on how to color correct your footage, especially if you're using log footage, which is high dynamic range footage. So that whole video covers what the heck log is. So if you guys are wondering why I'm talking about log, and no, it's not a log that you put on a fire. So basically what we're going to do is use the story blocks footage. So that opening sequence that you just saw in the opening of this video, I did not shoot that footage. It was actually downloaded from story blocks. Now this is also log footage. It kind of looks kind of milky. And what we're going to be doing is using the curves to really accentuate and bring out the colors in that footage. So if you're interested in following along, you can use that footage. There's a link in the description box below to that particular list of all of that footage that I used. So yeah, I'll stop talking now. Let's go ahead and jump into Premiere and I'll show you how to use it.
All right, so here we are in Premiere Pro. Here are two clips from Storyblocks that we are going to grade together and go over the curves. So the first step is to go into the color workspace. Now this pops open the Lumetri color panel, which we will use, and also be sure to toggle over to select your Lumetri scopes. And I cover how to read this Luma waveform and how to set that up in my previous color grading tutorials, so be sure to watch that. You can follow along still and I'll kind of show you how to use it in this tutorial, but I won't be going over all of the details. So the first step here is to brighten this image up, create more contrast. So I actually like to use the curve to do this. Now the RGB curves, this white line, this affects the luminance of the image. Now if you click at this top one and you drag it over, you can see it makes the image more bright. And as I do that, it raises up the Luma waveform closer to 100, and that's what we want to do. And we don't have to bring it all the way up to 100, but enough that is fitting for the eye so it's not clipping. So I'm just gonna lower that just a tad bit more. And then also to bring this down closer to zero to create more contrast on the opposite end of this Luma curve here, I'm going to just drag this to the right and you can see that it just brings in a lot more shadow and contrast. So that is how you adjust the brightness and contrast of the image when you're grading log footage. Now below the RGB curves, if I just toggle that down, you'll find the hue saturation curves. Now this allows you to do more detailed color grading. Now hue versus sat. Hue is just a fancy word for color. So just think of hue as any type of color on the spectrum, and sat is for saturation. How much saturation, how much depth of color is in each color. So you can see the verse as the, how much saturation do you want in a particular hue? So for example, if I wanted to take this dropper and select a color, a hue, let's say this blue color, it'll create three dots from which I can adjust the saturation. So if I bring this up, you'll see that that blue just gets far more saturated. If I bring it down, it desaturates it. You see, and there's also blue in her jeans as well. So that's why it kind of looks like you're desaturating most of the image here, because most of this image is blue. So I'm going to saturate this up a bit just to bring out more color, like so. Now we can also select another hue. Let's select the red color here. And let's also bring up the saturation. So let's just move this bar so we can get a clearer view here. And here I'm just going to pop this up as well. So you see that difference there? And let's bring that up like so. And you can extend these to encompass more color if you want. So more orange or more pink color. And if you ever need to delete anything, just hold down the command key or control key if you're on a PC, and you would just select that and it would go away. And to create a new one, just click and then you can bring that back up again. So this is looking pretty good. I think what else I will do is probably just, and here I'll probably go up to creative and probably add some vibrancy to the image just to overall saturate some of the colors of the image that are not saturated enough. And I think that's looking pretty good. So we can see the before and the after here. And then the next curve is hue versus hue. So this is changing a color of an existing color. So for example, if we wanted to give this a little bit more of an orange teal look, let's say that's what you were going for, you would just select this blue color here. And then we can actually, when you click that center dot, it gives you the whole spectrum. So if I needed to go more purple, I could bring this down to get really experimental here, or you could just slightly push this up just to change this to more of a teal color. See that? So now it's no longer the baby blue, it's more of a teal color. And let's say for the red, we wanted to make that a little bit more orange, just select that. And then what we can do is just drag this down to the orange color. And what we're going to have to do here is actually widen this to encompass more of that red. And then we can bring this down. So see how it's more kind of a pinkish red. And as I bring this down, it gets more of an orangey red. So now if I turn this off, before you see it was more pink and blue, and now it's more of like a teal and kind of orangish color, if that's what you're going for. But let me just undo all of this since I'm not really going for the orange and teal look for this particular. So I'm going to Command Z until all of those dots disappear. Now let's move on to the next one, hue versus luma. Now this next curve, I don't use that often, but essentially it allows you to adjust the brightness of a particular color. So for example, if I select this blue color, let's go ahead and roll on over here. And if I reduce that color, see how it just darkens just that color? And then it'll just brighten that color, but it can get really ugly really quickly. You see how it gets all distorted. So I don't really use this. If you are using it, you would probably just do a very subtle dip just to darken that color a little bit, but I'm not going to use it for this clip, but I just wanted to demonstrate it for you. Now, let's go ahead and move on to Luma versus Sat. So this controls the saturation of the brightness in the image. So if you select a particular area here, so let's say we select this cloud up here. If we increase this, it'll just add more saturation in those areas. So there's a hint of blue in those areas. So as I increase it, it gets more blue in the sky. And as you widen that, it can encompass more. So we're really adding more saturation into the sky if we wanted to go for that effect. I don't think it looks very good. It kind of gets a little bit distorted, but I just wanted to demonstrate that you can really add in more saturation into your skies if you need to, just by selecting an area and then boosting that saturation if you so like. So I'm just going to uncheck that so that one's not active. And the last one is just sat versus sat. This is just controlling the saturation of the saturated areas of the image. So for example, if I was going to select this blue color here, I could reduce that saturation or boost it. So it's really just taking saturated areas and either increasing it even further or reducing that saturation. So let me just undo that, and I'll do the same thing to the red here. So if I really wanted to make this red red, you can see what's happening when I boost that. It just makes it that much more vibrant. And as I spread these, you can see that that saturation encompasses the full light. So I think that looks pretty cool. Having that extra saturation there really makes that color pop. And if you really want the red tones in your video to stand out, you can definitely play around with saturation versus saturation curves. So then the next shot here is in the same scene. However, there's also yellow. So what we can do is we can actually right click and copy this clip. And then on this clip, we can right click and paste attributes and just paste all of the Lumetri color. We don't need to copy over the motion. So we're going to paste Lumetri color and bam, we can already see that it's made a difference if we turn this off and then on. But let's say we want to saturate this yellow even further. So this is where I would actually go up and select this yellow color here from the hue versus saturation, because again, we're controlling the saturation of a color. And this is where I can boost this up and you can see the difference there. It just becomes far more intense. And if I drop it, it becomes far less saturated. So I'm just going to boost this up a bit and we can kind of, we don't want to encompass too much of this because then it starts to get into the skin tones and I don't want to saturate her skin tones that much in the image. So just boost it up a bit there. And now that's looking pretty good, like so. And if I turn that off and on, you can see the difference in the image. So one other thing that I added here was a letterbox on top. I use this site called Film Crux. They have a great free resources. So they have these free letterbox templates, and the letterbox are the black boxes that give it that cinematic look. So you just like subscribe to their newsletter and you can download their letterboxes. So I just took the letterbox from their 1080p preset, the Whiplash. So I just took this and I dragged it into my project panel and then drag it on top of the footage, extend it out. And now when we play it back, you can see it has a nice cinematic look.
So that's how you use curves in Premiere Pro. Hopefully you're no longer intimidated, because curves can be intimidating. But now you guys have the tools so you can go out in the world and you can conquer your footage without fear. And that is what this channel is about. Just hit that fear on the ground and don't let it take over, because I know how it is. So that's all for this video, you guys. Please leave a comment below. Let me know what else you guys want to learn, because this channel is all about you guys and the community of learning. So I look forward to hearing and reading the comments below, and I will see you guys next time. Bye. If you never come around, how we ever gonna be? If you're always on the ground, then you're never gonna see.